getting ready to have a cup of coffee, a nice little chat, hang out with my friends while I sort seeds. It really is all about, number one, keeping your seeds in a cool, dry place so that they will last longer, and number two, organizing it so that you know what you have and where it is and you can get to it quickly when you need it. Hi, not a lot of room right here. Today I'm going to reorganize my seeds and just kind of talk with you and hang out. I'm trying to figure out how I want to set this all up. I've been in this gardening game, about 7 or 8 years now. And I started with just a little bag, like a grocery bag of seed packets, because I would only buy 4 or 5 packets each season when I started. I wasn't growing very many things. I wasn't growing a lot of varieties of things. And then slowly, as we moved from my mom's down here and I started my little cottage garden / market garden / potager garden out at the south end of our house, I got more seeds. And then last year I tripled the size of that garden and I have a lot more seeds. And this year I am adding another garden that's just about three times the size of that one. So now I'm gonna have 2 gardens. The one south of our house is 25 by 75 roughly. The one that's out here is about 50, it's either 40 wide or 50 wide, and the length of it is, I wanna say, 100 or 120 feet long. So it's significantly bigger. That being said, my seed collection has grown exponentially along with my garden. I upgraded from a garbage bag to, from a grocery bag into bins. And then this year I'm upgrading, dun dun dun, into these things. Now, you probably have seen these. If you've watched very many gardening channels, I wasn't the first one to figure this out. These are photo storage boxes and they're a great size for storing packets of seeds. So while I'm doing these, while I'm putting everything in these, I am also going to be double checking my seeds inventory list to make sure that it's up to date with all the stuff that I currently have. These seeds just came in the mail. So I need to add these to my seed inventory. All right, here we go. Let's start arranging these pumpkins. Pete's watermelon. Isn't that pretty? Why would a person want to grow all these vegetables? Isn't it a lot of work? Yeah, it is a lot of work. But look at what you're gonna get. You're gonna have locally produced fruits and vegetables that you know how they're grown. You can choose to grow them organically without any chemical pesticides. You can have all these varieties, these heirloom varieties that have been grown the same type of plant for years and years. And you're gonna get a different kind of variety than you get at the grocery store. At the grocery store, they're gonna have the perfect red tomato, the perfect green head of lettuce, orange long carrots. But they're not gonna probably have, what have I got in here? These cosmic purple carrots with a little bit of a spice taste that are great for fingerling carrots on as a side dish. They're not gonna have, most likely, this delicata squash with this great, cool, green variation, whatever it's called in the skin. And if we small local farmers don't keep producing these heirloom varieties, they're gonna die out eventually because the big mass producers aren't gonna make that. That's not what the grocery stores wanna sell. Another reason to have this kind of variety in your garden is because you need that kind of variety in your diet. Each color variation, the purple tomatoes have different vitamins and nutrients than the red ones do. And same goes with all the different plants in your garden. The more variety and more rounded out your garden is, the more variety in your diet, the healthier you'll be. I think I'm gonna pour my coffee now. do you take your coffee? I like mine tan. I need to move these off my keyboard so I can double check and make sure that I have them all on my list. I love these. I was really tempted to get the clear ones and just have clear and clear and clear because it's kind of in my nature, but I decided to go for color. I know my friend Tara will be proud of me. Oh, I need to get out my label maker. What color box should I put tomatoes in? Orange, red, blue, purple. Oh, so exciting. Power it on, create label. Oh, it's got different font. It's got fancy font, guys. Ooh. Print. It printed. Da, da, da. Oh, that might be perfect. Look! First seeds going in the first seed organizer box. And it didn't click. And bam! Sip o' coffee. Coffee break. Guys, let me show you this, by the way. If you're a coffee drinker, you need this stainless steel French press in your life. It will be a game changer. So I used to brew coffee in just like a coffee maker. I've had lots of Keurig coffees, not my own, but at other people's houses at work and stuff. And then I got a Bialetti, which is kind of like a percolator. It's a little two-part. It's got a little part down here where you put the water and then the little like pitcher kettle top, and it screws on, you do it on the stove. And then someone introduced me to French pressed coffee. Oh, it was like the world opened up for me. And my first two French presses were glass and they broke. One, I was just brewing coffee and I picked it up and the bottom, the glass like separated the jar part and the bottom, and coffee just went everywhere and made a big mess. And the second one broke in the sink when I was washing it. So then I was like, well, I wonder if they make French press out of anything else. And I came across this stainless French press on Amazon. Love it. I tell people about it all the time. Also because it will keep your coffee warm. It's an insulated, it's double walled. And they have it in several sizes, and I'm gonna put an affiliate link down below. And if you get one, I might make a little bit of money off of it, but I would recommend it to you even if it wasn't an affiliate link. I use it every day. Love it, I tell all my friends about it. Squashes get a yellow box. Squashes are gonna get more than one yellow box. Two yellow boxes. Here on the homestead, I catch on quicker to what I need to do for the animals than what I need to do in the garden. But I also think that it's really an important part of our homestead, so that's why I keep working at it. That's why I wanna get better at it. And you know, really, I've come a long ways. When you look back at some of my first gardens, an unbelievable difference than what last year's garden was. Last year's garden was just really nice. I have all the seed packets in boxes. I have all the boxes labeled. Yay! Probably some of these labels won't make sense to anybody but me, because there was like not enough of a certain kind to give it its own category, but at the same time I didn't know what else of the other categories to put it in. This has eggplants, okra, and then some other weird Thai double blue butterfly pea. I'm not even sure that's in the right group. I might fix it later. So I just called these fruiting because the eggplant and the okra are fruit of the plant. My point to all this is when you organize your seeds, you have to do it in a way that's gonna make sense to you so that when you're ready to go plant seeds, you can find the one you need quickly. I also did double check and make sure that I had the same seeds that I have out here are the same seeds in my inventory list, so that should I need to see if I want to order more seeds or if somebody's offering me seeds, I can quickly check and see what I have and what I need. All right, now I need to get these in the box. And I had thought I was gonna organize it by when they get planted, but I don't think I'm gonna do that. I think I'm just going to put them in there by, where's my case? By types, by things that in my mind get grouped together. All right, so this makes sense to me. Let me give you a quick close-up look at it. Starting from back to front, watermelon, melon, cucumber, pumpkins, squash, onions, and carrots on that side. And on this side, we've got peppers, tomatoes, other fruiting veg, beans, leaf vegetables, stem vegetables, beets and chard, and brassica. So to me, that makes sense. Look how pretty that looks. I think that I'm happy with that. And then in the other case, I'll put these three: herbs, sunflowers, and flowers. The cool thing about this system is it's really easy to switch out. I mean, if I want to, I could totally redo all the labels. I could reorganize it. I can expand it. This is gonna save me time because I'm not gonna have to go digging through that bin every time I wanna find a packet of seeds, which is great. It really is all about, number one, keeping your seeds in a cool, dry place so that they will last longer. And number two, organizing it so that you know what you have and where it is and you can get to it quickly when you need it. That is really a key thing for any organization system, for your gardening tools, for your seeds, for your potting supplies, all of that. Is it where you need it? Can you find it? Can you get to it quickly? Because gardening is work as it is, and if you can set up these systems that make each task simpler and easier to do, then you're more likely to do them, right? So if my seeds are in a bag, some of them under the bed and some in a closet somewhere and maybe some in the freezer, and I don't know where my potting soil is and where are my gloves, and I threw the trowel in the garage, it's gonna take me longer to get ready to do the gardening project than the gardening project itself would be. So that is one of the reasons that I love organization systems like this. Thanks for hanging out with me and keeping me company while I organize my seeds today. I'm super happy with the way it turned out, and I would love to see your organization system, so let me know how you do it. Last week, I made a video about how I plan my garden calendar, what I'm gonna plant throughout the year. So you can click right over here and you can see how I do that, how I get it set up. I shared some resources with you that are gonna make that easier. Thanks for watching. Have a great week.